Hi guys, this is Sajid Khan. You're watching me on Films of India. I do know that I'm very good at putting my foot in my mouth. I do know that I'm very good at speaking the blatant truth. I come from a very humble and a very poor background. I lost my credibility of my sense of humor. I was making funny films, but personally, I was getting unfunnier.
Sajid ji, welcome to the show, Celebrity Unplugged.
Thank you very much, Kabir. Thank you very much. And thank you very much for calling me Sajid ji.
Okay. Now that we got that out of the way, we saw you hosting Comedy Nights. And are we going to be seeing you hosting?
Wasn't bad, right?
It wasn't bad.
Quite,
I
like
that rope wala trick, ke wo rope bhaade par hai. That was nice. Your Jugalbandi with Ritesh was also nice.
Yeah. The channel called me and they asked me to do one or two episodes. Then I spoke with Kapil and Kapil said, bhai, do it na. So I said, okay, fine. I also knew that, you know, I was returning to television for almost after 7 to 8 years because the last episode of Ikke Peka, my flagship show, which started in 95, I ended that show in 2008 because I was beginning to write Houseful. So I didn't want to do television. Yeah, but I did award functions. I did many various games, shows, reality shows as a judge. But I never hosted. So hosting Comedy Nights with Kapil, which is already such a big popular brand, was some sort of a challenge for me. And I took it up because I said, might as well, you know, I have the gift of the gab to make people laugh. And that's what I'll do. And I was very happy with the response that I got.
Right.
There was no negativity from Kapil's fans, which I thought I would get, you know.
Because you also introduced yourself very well that, you know, that Kapil is not here. So, this is Kapil's show. And
but it is like it's like me hosting my show and then
somebody else stepping in
for a couple. There will be a certain degree of animosity towards that person. Thank you for being nice to me.
And another thing, you've always, like you said, you know, you've got a very good sense of humor. You have this penchant for mimicry and acting. You never treaded that line. You got into.
I have. All through my childhood, that's what I've done. You know, Kabir, I'm one of those very unique cases of people who knows everything about anything only because of movies.
Right.
Are you understanding? So if you talk science to me, I've probably seen something in a science fiction movie to remember a particular word. If you talk geography to me, I've particularly seen it in some certain James Bond movie or a Yash Raj movie.
To
that location, that place, okay, this happens over there. If you talk anything about anything, my references are movies. So I used to do mimicry. I still do mimicry. But you know, mimicry is like riding a cycle. You get off it and then when you jump back on it, it takes a little while to pedal and come back to it. I put it in all my films. I keep having fun. When I was growing up, we were only watching movies and talking about movies, me and my friends, and imitating whether how Jeetu ji danced or how Mithun Chakraborty danced. So that is what we were doing.
You once said that, you know, I felt success was slightly denied to me because of this whole popular image that I had of this nuisance value guy on television.
I have said many things in my life, which I particularly don't regret. Yes, but I do realize that they were also spoken for effect.
Okay.
I don't know whether I'm a good filmmaker. I don't know whether I'm a good host. I don't know whether I'm a good television personality or a film celebrity. I really don't know whether I'm good at it. I do know that I'm very good at putting my foot in my mouth. I do know that I'm very good at speaking the blatant truth, which eventually does get you into trouble. So what I have done is I have curbed my enthusiasm over the last 2 years and decided, okay, if I don't like something, I'm not going to say it's horrible. I'm just going to have a smile and say better luck next time or wish you all the best.
Be a little more diplomatic.
A little more, no. In my case, a lot more.
A lot more?
Yeah. So when I said this, that success was denied to me, I didn't mean that success was denied to me. I meant the recognition which comes with that certain success was definitely denied to me because you had, okay, think about it. Nah? You have this guy, this 20-year-old boy on television in the mid-90s making fun of films.
The whole hamming scenes thing which you used
not
to do.
Just hamming, making wild predictions as to which film is going to work at the box office and which film is not going to work and giving gyan to filmmakers that this is going to work and the childish, stupid, but funny. Incredibly funny, notorious, impish is
very
the right word. Impish is the right word. And then suddenly he decides to make a film. So the whole industry is waited, oh, achcha bachchu. And then the film does well, you know. So there is a certain degree of deniability. Haan, yaar, chalo, theek hai, fluke tha. फिर सेकंड फिल्म आई हाउसफुल, ठीक है ना, फ्लूक था. थर्ड फिल्म के बाद ओके, साजिद खान ऑफ ब्रांड सिनेमा ना, वो हैम सीन्स, लाउड स्लैपस्टिक कॉमेडी, दैट ओके. आई वॉज गेटिंग बिगर एंड बिगर विद एवरी फिल्म, बट आई वॉज ट्राइंग टू टेक होल्ड ऑफ योर यू नो कॉलर एंड से लिसन, टेक नोटिस ऑफ मी, आई एम अ बिग फिल्म मेकर, आई एम अ बिग फिल्म मेकर, टेक नोटिस ऑफ मी, डोंट मेक मी स्टैंड एट द साइड, मेक मी स्टैंड एट द सेंटर. व्हाई? If you don't believe I'm a big filmmaker, how will I believe I'm a big filmmaker? And if I don't believe I'm a big filmmaker, how will you believe I'm a big filmmaker? I lost my credibility of my sense of humor with Hey Baby, Houseful, Houseful 2. I was making funny films, but personally I was getting unfunnier.
Okay, okay.
I'm telling you the truth. I was not enjoying myself. I wanted you to respect me. Listen, you can't respect me because I'm telling you, hey, respect me, okay? I'm given 3 hits. I was in my head childish. I wouldn't say thank God Himmat Wala happened, but in a way, for me personally, Himmat Wala happened, and it not just brought me humbling down to the ground. Tumbling down is the right word, but certainly I feel it changed me as a person.
It did.
Yeah, it made me realize. Listen, man, it's only a film. It's success and failure are part of you. You fail in exams and you pass in exams and you. Not every student comes first in the class. It's okay. It doesn't mean that the student who came last is a failure.
Right.
You know. Fortunately, Hamshakals made the business. It did. It did 64 crores. But in terms of reputation, it's supposed to be a very terrible film. That's what people tell me. And I listen to them. Earlier, I would not even listen to people. तुझे क्या पता? But मुझे मत सिखा. Today, I listen to people. Are you understanding? It's been almost a year. I've been working on my script. A year in my life. The only time I worked on a script for a year was during Hey Baby. You know, that no, actually 2 years. I worked on Hey Baby for 2 years. 2005, I wrote it. 2007, it released. So I'm taking my time now before I make my next film, which will be not sort of a, oh, Sajid Khan's made a comeback. No, but it'll be, hey, listen, man, Sajid Khan made a damn good film. Yeah. That nice. Is the approach and nice. Not the 100 crores and 200 crores.
Very nice.
If that happens, that happens. That's what I
feel. Yeah, that'll be like a...
Yeah, so I think... There's a certain degree of maturity and growing up. I'm also going to turn 44 in November.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Scorpion.
Sagittarian and Scorpion.
Ah, okay. Fair enough.
Yeah.
Fair
why? Enough. You're the same?
I'm a Scorpion.
Okay.
I'm a
Scorpion. I like girls. I do.
Okay. Moving on. You said that there was a time, this is, I think, when you were doing the shows on TV, you were doing about 5 shows a week and every few months, one would go off air.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So, like, tell us about that time. What exactly happened?
Jack of all, master of none. That's, I think, that's how I would describe myself. Bhand Mirasi. I used to call myself a Bhand Mirasi. You know, my logic was, laughter at any cost, paise ke liye kuch bhi karega. You call me to host an award function, I'll do it. You call me to host a building meeting, I'll do it. I'm telling you, no, there was a time when I hosted on national TV, Housie, national TV, all India, but on the same time on Sunday mornings on my local cable one also I used to host Housie. Because for me, money is money. I just wanted to get out of the house and get a job.
Very nice.
Because my mom felt I was a good for nothing. And so I thought for a while I was a good for nothing. And I started realizing that, listen, I have 2 things which work in my favor. Definitely not a face, as you can see, but one, I have the gift of the gab. I improv a lot.
Yeah, yeah.
2, I think I can make people laugh. So let me try to push it to the limit where I can. But what happens is something which is a good thing over a period of time done again and again and again becomes an overexposure.
Right.
And that is what happened to me when I started my career 95 till 2005, 10 years. Na? I said, yaar, maine jab shuru kiya tha, tab main 22-23 saal ka tha. I'm in my early 30s. Now I'm doing the same thing. When will I move ahead? That's where I decided to stop television and start writing Hey Baby. Man.
Nice. The progression. You said that, you know, seeing your father's journey from glory to gloom taught you not to get carried away by success or guided
by failure. But I don't. Success and failure are part of your lives. I strongly believe in that. I come from a very humble and a very poor background. Me and my sister literally had to... I don't know how to say this, but we didn't have money to pay our electricity bill. So we used to, in the day we were very happy because the windows used to be open, there used to be natural light. Shaam ko 7 baje candle jalate the. Because we did not have money to pay the electricity bill. So I used to go to the Jubich and dance and do action scenes with my friend and do mimicry and then ask people, okay, 10 paisa, 20 paisa, we entertained you, I'll pay us.
You've done that, okay.
Of course, yeah. I've stolen things. I'm telling you, I don't hide my past. So when you come up from that beginning, na, you don't feel like, I personally feel you are a failure in life when you are not a good son, when you're not a good brother, when you're not a good husband, when you're not a good friend, when you're not a good father. Are you understanding? And many other rishtas.
Yeah.
But no matter how successful you may be in terms of monies or your work or your professional life, if personally people don't like you, then for me, you're a failure. You know, whether it's been my success or whether it's been the last two films, I've always had my bunch of friends around me. You know, I did screw up in my life, and I think he also will admit it, that the one dark period in my life was, and his life too, was my disassociation with Sajid Nadedwala as friends, because we were thicker than brothers. Mm. And thank God, we are back to laughing and talking about it. And you know what happens with guy friends? When you're guy friends with somebody for 17 years and like brothers, when you'll fight and when you'll get back, surprisingly, you'll never remember the bad times. It doesn't happen with women. Women bring up the bad times.
Pretty bold statement. Pretty sensible statement also.
Yeah, women bring up the bad times. You know, you had said this to me then. Arey, but you had done this. You know, guys just forget about it.
Yeah.
That's what I feel. And today I'm so happy that Sajid Nadedwala and me are one. And eventually we will be working together also. And why not? Yeah?
Wonderful, wonderful. Okay, with the advent of social media, I'm going to ask you this. What is probably the meanest thing you've heard about yourself online?
Lots of things. I don't particularly read reviews. I've never read reviews in my life. I stopped reading it, I think, in my 9th standard. When the report card came out, I said, I don't want to read anything that depresses me. At the same time, I don't want to read anything which will make me stand on a chane ka jhaad, you know.
Hmm.
That you're so good and you're so this and you're so bad. I don't. My assistants also have been warned or requested now that don't come and tell me about a review or about what somebody's written on Twitter. I've just joined Twitter.
Okay.
3 months ago.
Okay.
At the insistence of the agency which is handling me.
Okay.
And yes, it has brought a certain positive change in me and my outlook towards others and people's outlooks towards me. I personally feel, you know, people, they judge you by what they see and hear of you.
Right.
Twitter somewhere eliminates that. And see, you can't fool people, because who are the people on Twitter? People like you and me, who are sensible enough to understand also the pattern of a person who writes. Are you understanding? I'm not into the pattern where I think I will come out of a trial a week, because I don't attend trials. I don't go for trials. I don't go for parties. And I think people are sensible enough that they don't invite me anymore, you know, because I don't know what to do at a party. I really don't know. Seriously, I don't drink. I don't.
You don't drink?
No,
okay.
I've never touched alcohol.
Okay.
Yeah, but my face says something else. I know. It's called lack of sleep, water retention. So I think Twitter somewhere helps you. It does help you to reach out. And today, God forbid, if you say something about me in the press, earlier I did not have anything to answer back.
Right, right.
Today I can answer you back on my Twitter thing. You know, this is untrue or this is absolutely true, and this is what this person has. Yeah, so I guess it does. I've started interacting with people on Twitter. And of course, there are trolls and there are haters, which are there everywhere. And you have to respect them also, because yaar, bachpan mein hum log bhi karte the. Hum log bahut karte the yaar, seriously. Aisa kaun hai jo school mein camp pe nahi jata tha aur kisi ko chadar dal ke 10 log nahi marte the? Marte the. Aur jab chadar hatta tha, kaun mara? Main nahi. Wo yahi karte the. To wo theek hai yaar. You have to take that also.
It's been fun interviewing you. And thanks for coming on the show. And
thank you very much.
All the best for the future.
Thank you very much. Seriously, it's something very nice about this boy in the next 5 seconds. It's his absence.
It's almost like if someone is holding your tongue and you try to talk.
Hmm.
Try to talk with your tongue. I get media people saying, you tell me one thing I can write about your personal life. You tell me.
And are we going to be seeing Jackie Shroff coming out with an autobiography?
Yeah, for sure. It's too early at the moment. But there are so many questions and answers being asked by guys like you that my whole life is on the bloody plate.